From what the trench is to the mysteries that lie within it, join me as we explore what did scientists really see in the Mariana Trench. Let's talk frankly here. The oceans of the world are massive. It does cover 70% of our world, and not just on the surface, but under it as well. Between the seven oceans, there's so much water in depth that if you actually deconstructed the entire world's landmass and put it into all the oceans evenly, there would still be enough ocean to go 2 miles deep. And that's just an estimate. There's probably even more water down there than we realize, as you'll understand. Let's start with a human. A human on top of the ocean is quite literally a speck. And even if you were to put a large animal beside it like an elephant or a giraffe, that speck wouldn't be much larger as the ocean is that vast and deep. Furthermore, despite our technology, there are limits to what we can do within the ocean itself. For example, if you love scuba diving, you'll know that there are limits to what you can do. Sure, some gear is better suited for diving than others and can thus allow deeper dives, but the average for recreational diving is only about 120 feet, which compared to the size and scale of the ocean is paltry at best. Furthermore, with shipwrecks like the Lusitania, you'll find that the bottom of the ocean isn't as consistent as one might think. The Lusitania, for example, was over 700 feet long, yet it was found in waters that were only about 300 feet deep. So if there was something down there to cause it to fall unevenly, it would actually be sticking out of the water, which would have made it easier to find, actually. But again, even 300 feet deep isn't even close to what the oceans have to offer. They go so much deeper than that. Not that you should do this on your own, for if you dare to go beyond 300 feet into the oceans with standard or even above standard fishing gear, you'll find yourself struggling in those depths because of the decompression sickness. That being said, the world record for free diving is actually just over 700 feet into the depths, which is very impressive, not to mention very dangerous. And that diver, Herbert Ditch, is very lucky to have made it not just down there, but back alive. Especially since he did this in one breath. As for the scuba diving world record, that one belongs to Ahmed Gaber, who went an incredible 1,089 feet below the ocean's depths. Both of these are truly incredible and true feats of humanity pushing the bounds of what they can do. And yet, that's still only a mere fraction of what the ocean can be in terms of its depths. In context, the average depth of the ocean is estimated to be around 12,000 feet from surface to bottom. Which means that Ahmed Gaber didn't even reach 1/12 of the ocean's depths. And it is not just people who struggle to go that low. Certain sea animals can't do it either. For example, the blue whale, the biggest whale on Earth, can only go a little over 1,600 feet. And United States submarines can only match what the blue whales can do. Or going any deeper can result in the ocean's natural pressure crushing said submarine like a tin can. Which just goes to show that whether it be man, machine, or beast, the ocean depths are not for everyone. And that leads us to the Mariana Trench, which in many ways is the deepest part of the ocean that we know about. This is mainly because the trench is 36,000 feet below sea level. It's so deep that if you don't have a specially made craft, the pressure of the ocean would crush you in an instant. Furthermore, because of how deep it is, there is no light from the sun or sky that reaches down there, so thus the only lights you'll have are the ones on your ship. Fun fact, only 4 humans in history have ever been able to go to the Mariana Trench. The first 2 were in 1960. Swiss oceanographer Jacques Picard and USN Lieutenant Don Walsh went down in a special submarine and are in fact the 2 humans to go the deepest into the ocean. However, they only lasted about 20 minutes before their submarine had to be surfaced because of the pressure of the ocean. The other came 52 years later in the form of the one and only James Cameron, who went down in a single-man pod and stayed there for quite some time before surfacing back up. Then in 2019, American Victor Vescovo took a sub that actually hit the very bottom of the trench and stayed there for 4 hours. While their accomplishments are noteworthy in every way, it goes to show that while they've been to the bottom of the trench or close to it, they don't really know everything that's down there. Until we get a craft down there that can be there for extended periods, there's no way of knowing all that resides with the Mariana Trench. What's more, there are some who believe that there are places nearby that are even deeper than the trench, though this has not been definitively proven. But let's get to the heart of the matter. What have scientists seen within the Mariana Trench? What signs of life or other things have been encountered or viewed down there? Well, honestly, that's a bit of a tricky question. Because of the longest period of time, or at the very least since we knew about the Mariana Trench, we didn't believe that there was anything down there. And while we did have two people go and reach the trench in 1960, they didn't have the tools necessary to truly explore it, nor the time, as we mentioned. However, James Cameron's adventure allowed scientists to get a more notion of what was down there, and it's a lot more than you would expect. First and foremost, he found loads of microorganisms and even microbial mats. Furthermore, there were plenty of bacteria that were more than happy to live in the lightless and cold waters of the trench. Given how life works on Earth, that shouldn't be too much of a surprise. But the more that Cameron looked around, and the other expeditions both manned and unmanned, the more that he found, including bigger things. Before we talk about said bigger things, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way, you don't miss any of our weekly videos. So, what other things have lived or do live in the Mariana Trench? Well, we'll never fully know the extent of things that Cameron and others found because scientists aren't willing to show all that they've found. But some things have been released. For example, they did confirm that they see massive clams and unique jellyfish within the Mariana Trench. This is impressive because anything, hard-shelled or soft-bodied, would be under enormous pressure from the waters themselves. So to survive, there means that they've adapted to the waters. However, Cameron's and others' expeditions also show that there are more mysterious creatures down there that they don't know how to explain. One example was a fish that was discovered on the way to the bottom of the trench that looked like no fish ever seen before, and at one point, a metallic-shaped entity appeared on sensors during descent and actually cut out contact with the craft. When the craft returned contact, the entity was gone. Going back to the jellyfish, the one that they found within the trench was unlike anything they had ever seen before. It had an alien-like body and it glowed red and yellow. The glowing can be attributed to bioluminescence, for as noted, there is no light down in the Mariana Trench via the sun, so many aquatic species actually glow in order to make sure they can see and avoid predators at times. Heading now to the more basic of creatures, there are a series of crustaceans that are like shrimp on the floor of the Mariana Trench that are both familiar but still atypical. How are these atypical? That would be because of their size. You see, up on the surface, shrimp only get to a certain size, but on the floor of the trench, they apparently were over 1 foot in size. Could you imagine if Red Lobster got a hold of them? There are also some terrors that have been documented within the trench, such as the goblin shark, the anglerfish, the barrel eye fish, the hatchet fish, and much, much more. How about a giant toxic amoeba? Or a small octopus called the Dumbo octopus that is one of the deadliest of its species? Or the frilled shark, which is a remnant from the age of dinosaurs? Yeah, that lives in the trench as well. But along the lines of the frilled shark, there are rumors and beliefs as to what else could be down there. Many are wondering if there is something even deadlier lying within the trench waiting to be found or awakened. We speak, of course, of the megalodon. For those who don't know, the megalodon was the apex predator of the ancient world. It lived about 23 million plus years ago, and through it came a harrowing look at the feeding frenzy that was the ancient world. This wasn't just an ancient shark. It was a 60-foot multi-ton behemoth that would eat just about anything in sight. It was so aggressive and huge that it needed to eat 1 to 2 tons of food a day just to survive. And because of its powerful teeth, few, if any, creatures could actually harm it outside of other megalodons. If you're wondering, was this creature really real? The answer is yes. We have plenty of bones, jaws, and tons of teeth from megalodons that have died and fossilized. Although, ironically, when the megalodon teeth were first discovered, they were so big, almost a foot at times, that they were felt to be rocks instead of teeth. Irony. Anyway, a series of events led to the megalodons dying out, not the least of which was massive extinction events on Earth leading to a lesser amount of food to eat. This turned the megalodons into cannibals, and their numbers plummeted after that. However, with the finds of the frilled fish and the coelacanth, we know the ancient creatures have survived the time of the dinosaurs and beyond. And many rumors have claimed that the megalodon could be out there somewhere, including in the depths of the Mariana Trench, where no one would find it unless they went down there. So, could it be down there? Objectively speaking, yes, yes, it could. As we've already outlined, there are plenty of species of animals in the Mariana Trench, From single and multi-celled organisms to fish to octopuses, invertebrates, crustaceans, and more, all of whom had to adapt to the harsh conditions and pressures of the trench in order to survive. So naturally, if the megalodon was still alive, it too would have to adapt to the trench, its pressures, its temperatures, and its lack of light. It would be difficult, but not impossible. To that end, what the megalodon looks like now if it was in the trench would likely be different than how it was back in ancient times. The biggest problem that it would have in surviving down there is that while there are tons of life down there in the trench, they're usually very small creatures. Recall that we noted that the megalodon had to eat about 1 to 2 tons of food a day in order to survive? While you could get that amount from eating the species in the trench, it would be a lot of eating. In the ancient world, the megalodon would eat massive whales, dolphins, and other sea creatures that have a lot of girth, a lot of food for very little hunting. But here, in the trench, it would be the opposite. It would be a case of a lot of effort to get a little of food. Again, not impossible, but it would be a challenge, especially for the earliest versions of the shark. In truth, until we officially see one out there in the trench or the water surrounding them, we'll never truly know if the megalodon is alive. Sure, we can guess it's not based on certain facts and figures, but we've been wrong before about species being extinct. And that brings us to the final bit about the Mariana Trench. Despite us having gone down there via manned and unmanned probes and craft, there still is a lot that we don't know about the trench. Because it's dark, a very up-close and personal method must be used in order to help us look for everything and document everything. And the pressures of the waters make it so nothing but the most equipped craft can go down there, and even then, it's only for short periods of time. We already know for certain that there are creatures within the Mariana Trench that don't live anywhere else in the world. That's a fact. But how many more of these unknown creatures are down there? It would be foolish to hazard a guess. And that's why there are so many people who are aiming to go down to the trench and learn more about it. Because the more we dive down there, the more we will be able to find what lies beneath the waves. And when we discover the full extent of life down there, it'll open a whole new world of discovery. Thanks for watching, everyone. What do you think of this look at the Mariana Trench and the things that may or may not live in it? Which of these creatures do you think is the scariest of the lot from within the trench? Do you think we'll ever be able to research the trench in full? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.